We should be back. Fuck keyframe interval. I don't understand. Well, I think we're live. Okay. I don't know where home went, but we're gonna get into this shit. Oh god.
I'm here.
Mark Walburg, when he was younger.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Oh my.
He's so cute.
Hey, I'm your girlfriend, Marky Mark. Oh. What the worst part about having a wound is?
Hmm?
You can smell the dried up blood.
Girls, can we with them?
Sorry. If anybody who wanted that. Pretty good visualization.
He said girls can't live with them, can't shoot them. What the fuck? I think you got some problems, dude.
Let's ask someone else what they would do.
The jam on the video hit with the boxer. Hit ABC. Now we gotta have some good vibrations. It's the only way Germany's gonna get back on our tail.
Come on, guys. Let's hear your opinion.
I don't know. I kind of like the girl with the lips and make them real red. I like red. And find these shots.
What? Oh, good, your friend! The skeleton. I have to find the skeleton in specific. And I needed red. A girl with red lips. That's too many shots for me to remember.
We gotta find the skeleton, though. We're good.
So I gotta have some lyrics. And he said, make some reds. I think it's one of the clips.
It's the frog. Oh, it's okay. I make fun of every gaming culture war nowadays. Because they're all stupid. Anyways, well, nowadays they're dumb. They had a point, like, how long ago was it now? That's been a while, hasn't it? Since I've heard of it.
Well, you haven't been paying attention to it. It's been a lot of happenings. But I'm not gonna get into that right now, because this is about DJ Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch.
Controversial.
Yeah. Mark, well, you know Mark Wahlberg did commit a hate crime against an Asian by punching him in...
Wait, seriously?
I'm not kidding.
I would hope so, because like that should be in the footage here if that's the case.
Why is it skipping?
Why can't we kickstart this?
Why is the game skipping?
Make my video Fallout Boy? DJ Khaled?
Did I fuck up the frame skip or something? What? What?
Enable V-Sync, dude.
V-Sync?
Enable it. Click. No. Turn that. Go back to clock throttle, dude. And just turn on V-Sync. It's like right below it. It's like a little thing that says V-Sync enable. Now go back and turn on clock throttle. That's how you get the more accurate game running time. Up. Oh, there we go.
It's still skipping.
That might be the emulator, like, being dumb then. Don't worry about it. I think you just somehow managed to lag it. Good stuff, man.
I have an idea.
Make my video Flow Rider. Yes. Where's the skeleton? We gotta find him. So the most I know about video games and drama is that Gawker died. That's like the most I know right now. That's kind of like everything, isn't it?
Yeah.
Not even gaming. That's just like Hulk Hogan doing the... It's a terrible person killing another terrible thing, but I mean, hey.
It's a lake of fire killing a dragon. Neither one of those are any good to any human being, but at least one of the worst things
are
gone.
One of them now, right? I mean...
Yeah, the worst thing is gone.
My thoughts
on E3... I missed them! Shit! Sorry.
My thoughts on E3, I liked it. I think it was more well-rounded this year. None of them really blew me... Well, Zelda blew me away. I thought Zelda looked too good. But, outside of that, none of them really blew me away. They're all pretty solid. EA was funny. It was bad. Ubisoft was pretty bad. Sony, MS, and Nintendo were all pretty decent.
I need to redo my buttons. That's what the problem is here.
There's Crash. The Crash remakes I'm interested in. But, that's about it for Sony. Because everything else they announced is in development, aka never coming out until like 2019. So I'm not going to hear any of it. I'm going to forget those games exist because there's nothing. I mean, Spider-Man, I guess. But like everything else kind of looked all samey. They did have Ride to Hell 2.
Yeah, Ride to Hell 2 looks really good.
Oh, that one looks like a pretty good game.
I mean, Sony bought it if you like FPS games.
Yeah,
I guess.
I mean, yeah, if that's your thing, that's what they did pretty well.
I don't know why. It was running just fine, and now it's just fucking skipping.
Microsoft is if you like teraflops. It's pretty good.
Well, I mean, the format that Sony did was good.
Well, the format is presented. I mean, it's how they present it. I'd like them to keep doing that, but I don't know.
I just didn't care for, like, 50% of the games. God of War looked pretty cool.
My big problem with God of War is that they didn't call it God of War 5 or God of War 4 or whatever. Why is it always 1? Why is it always 1?
Because it's a reboot with a new deity. Even though they should just call it God of War Ragnarok or something.
Battlefield 1 is stupid. That's gonna confuse everybody. That's like...
It's about World War 1.
Yeah, but there's already been a Battlefield 1. Like, what if somebody asks and they're like, oh yeah, and they give you like the old game. God of War could be, that's true. But like, it's like some movie title shit. It's dumb, bad, don't do that ever when you're naming a game. But okay, no, I won't lie, Sony did get me with Spider-Man. But, Crash Bandicoot, I'm less salty about it now.
Yeah. What if it was an effect that did?
I don't know. I'm less salty about Crash now than I was. I was pretty mad. Oh yeah, we're just doing remakes and fucking Skylanders. Like, what the hell? You made it look like you were gonna announce a new game.
And I'm sad that I missed the skeleton.
I want to like Death Stranding, but I have no idea what it's about. All I know is that Kojima made it. That's... all I know about it.
Everybody said the same thing about Kojima's new game. He's like, I guess it was amazing. I don't know what the fuck it was.
I don't know what it was. I can't... I can't, like, say, oh man, I'm really excited for this game because I don't know what it is. I mean, it has Norman Reedus in it, which means my OTP is confirmed. I can already ship that fucking thing.
See, there's the red. I got the red like you asked for.
Zelda looks like I need to buy that fucking game now, but it's coming out in 1 year, so I'm stuck. Gotta wait 1 year for Zelda, that's no fun. I have to wait I don't know how many years for fucking new Spider-Man game.
Yeah, I must have did an effect to the song, because it's doing it now.
I mean, Insomniac Games making a Spider-Man game? Like...
It's literally something I did to the song.
And they say it's like, at the end of the conference, they're like, oh yeah, there's no date, and I'm like, aw. Now I'm never gonna play it, because I'm never gonna know what it's about.
Oh god.
I hope they don't stop updating me on Spider-Man, that's what I don't want to see. I don't want that to be like the last thing we see of it for like a couple of years. That's my only problem.
So now I know I fucked up the song.
Yeah, you did.
It was fine, and it got to that part and just started skipping again. And like nothing's wrong with the video play. So there was a button I had to press.
Like I said though, in terms of what I liked at E3, I want to play Zelda. I wish I was there to play it now. And then there was, I mean, Pokemon looked like Pokemon. Who would have thought a Pokemon game be bad? That's kind of, like, stupid. I mean... Oh, no, they didn't say that. No! Say it ain't so. Is that really where this is going?
We gotta appear to the hardcore demographic.
That guy that dumped the Zelda demo can... No,
he didn't
don't
succeed.
Oh, he did? What happened?
Because, like, how do you fucking dump a game with a long-ass line of people watching you do it?
Yeah, that's not a good idea. I'm guessing he got banned, like, faster than you can say, Well, did you see that image with the Reggie thing? It was like, you're leaking the game and you see this guy behind you. What do you do? Angry Reggie. I don't know what I would do. I'd probably feel really bad.
Alright, I botched this song. Sorry, no.
Yeah, dude, it's over.
Yeah.
I want the Waluigi amiibo too, but Zelda looked amazing. I'm not even gonna lie, that game is great. The only problem is, where am I gonna get all the free time to play that? I'm not gonna have any time to play that at all. Like, no time whatsoever, because it's coming out during my classes, so, like, rip me. That means I have to do all my homework early, and I hate doing that. That's what I did for Smash Brothers, and it was worth it. But... I don't want nothing to do with homework. And I hate doing homework early, but... That game's gonna make me do it.
What the fuck are these bell sounds coming from?
Well, since you fucked up...
Is that what you're fucking doing?
You must play the price!
Stop with the bells! You're fucking giving me tinnitus!
Or you can just sit there at the TV and drool and go back to the beginning.
Or quit.
There, I did the thing.
This seems a little way too incestuous to me.
Mark.
I don't remember brothers and sisters fighting like that.
Mark got arrested for. Oh yeah, I liked how you could burn stuff and like, yeah. Although Bill,
that's like a gif of the dude burning and then the wind blew and it just set the whole field on fire.
Yeah, that was something that looked pretty cool.
Yeah, that was too lewd.
And like, dude, like the fact that there's gonna be 100 and some temples that look like little mini dungeons like Link to the Past. And the Magneto weapon, like, you can finally be master of Magnet in a video game that isn't X-Men. And hit things with boulders.
Right now, I gotta believe.
And we got Wish Time.
Oh, they want me to have these shots.
Skeleton here? If he's not, this is a failure.
Make my video. Make my video skate. Peace. I'm out like shout.
Mark Wahlberg actually said, make my video.
I'm sure we can say that this E3 was a lot less disappointing than last year's in terms of overall. Because, like, I didn't really... Last year had, like, really big ups and really big downs. This year is just kind of, like, pretty good, solid, okay all around. I mean, it was alright. Like, nothing I hated. Like, Crash was the closest thing I got to Max Soap. Like, this year there's something for everybody. Paper Mario looks good. I mean, the visuals are amazing. I'm not gonna lie to you about that. I don't know about the gameplay.
The gameplay looks like it's... Well,
it's, I've heard it.
It's not quite Sticker Star, but I'm still very disappointed with what I've seen so far.
Yeah, like, I've heard it's better than Sticker Star was as a game, which is good. I mean, I guess that's nice. But I don't know. I'm probably not gonna buy it. Oh yeah, Shy Guy did kill Toad and sent it to Mario in a letter. That shit was dark. He opened the letter and there was like a dead Toad and I'm like...
How would you know
really?
He was dead?
Cause he had all the colors sucked, he was dead! He was like, he had like all the colors sucked out of him and he was just like lifeless and I'm like... Oh my god. That shit's dark! That's like the Mario equivalent of like mailing somebody's head to somebody. In that game anyways. That's messed up, man. Like, you know we have Detective Pikachu. Well, there's gonna be like, that's like the hint. That Detective Mario is gonna be the next thing they do. And that
I
one's actually
the fucking scenes I'm supposed to be looking for. But I gotta hope DJ Marky Mark have the finest quality videos.
With the chalk out. Yeah, they always have that. It's like, it's never... But yeah, this E3 had like something for everybody, I think. There's a lot of FPS and Sony stuff for people who are interested in that. Nintendo brought good stuff for Zelda people. It's actually, Zelda delivered a lot more than I thought it would.
Damn it, it did again! It's gotta be this game. I didn't press anything, literally.
Microsoft has that thing. I don't know what Microsoft did, but I know people liked it, I think.
No, that fixed it.
I don't know. I didn't buy an Xbox One, so I can't really say what they did impress me, but that's not like it's their. Oh yeah, there was Tekken 7, but I mean like, I also like how they all showed ukulele, like a PS4 and Microsoft had ukulele in their thing, which is funny.
I would get Tekken 7 on fucking Windows.
PC, yeah, Windows and PC. That's my opinion. I think this E3 was like a lot more well-rounded. There's a lot more stuff. It was weak compared to it because there wasn't like super bombshells, but I think I prefer that because like at that point you can enjoy a lot more of it because you're not going to expect something that big. The only disappointment was initially Crash. I'm going to say that I'm a little less skeptical about it now and I'm a little less upset. Like I'm a lot less upset about Crash now that I'm about it, because Kame can attest to how upset I was about Crash when it first happened.
He got up and threw his cat out the window.
No, my cat, no!
And the cat exploded. It was insane.
I slammed my door, but it was loud enough that Kame heard it, and actually, I went upstairs to get water, and my mother was like, what the hell happened down there? And I'm like, oh, I just fell. They are from the ground up. Yeah, that worries me, but it's also okay. I thought Activision was doing it at first, and I was like, oh, it's fucked. But it turns out Vicarious Visions is. And they do Skylanders, so it could be okay. Maybe. As long as they know what they're doing. That's what I'm concerned about. This does give us the chance, though. We can actually play Crash 1 without antiquated mechanics. That's one good thing. Like, if there's one good thing, if the remakes turn out good, we can finally play, like, a modern version of Crash 1. Because I like that game's level design and, like, ideas, but I don't like the saving system and the gems. So if they fix that, they'll be perfect. I'd like them to. They have no excuse not to at this point. Since they're remastering them from the ground up, they better do that.
So in order to fix the audio, I have to fucking press pause.
Mm-hmm. I heard yep. Clicking those buttons. Let's see what you did. Well, the PSM ports are good. That's the ones I beat.
No, don't stare at me like that.
I actually don't mind Crash on a D-pad. Because, well, depends on what D-pad. I'm using the PSP one, which is pretty good. But, like, the regular PlayStation D-pad is not fun for Crash, yeah. This video looks really organized.
It is.
What is that monkey doing?
He's patrolling the law.
That just went backwards, what?
You're asking questions and you shouldn't. So look, I gotta cut the light on and then flamenco dance with my best friend, the cartoon.
Marky Mark and the acid trip. Oh my god, please.
Marky Mark and the deletion key.
Oh, what else I want to say about Crash is that I don't mind it on D-pad as much if I have a good D-pad, because it's only in 8 directions anyways. There's not like, it's not like Mario 64 DS, where it's like you want the analog, because Crash was designed with 8 directions in mind, because Crash 1 and 2 were made before the analog. I don't know if Crash 3 actually has analog like directions, like more than 8 directions. I don't think it does, but I could be wrong. That's why Crash on the D-pad isn't terrible, depending on what one you're using.
Oh, there's a monkey with a drum, apparently.
Yeah, well, these monkeys are advancing, and then they got cut in half.
It's a fate worse than death. It's JoJo's Bizarre Adventure for CBS3, the stage cut attack.
Also, I should note, Rhythm Heaven came out today, so if anybody likes that game, because you should, you can go get it.
Isn't Rhythm Heaven, like, not WarioWare?
Rhythm Heaven Mega Mix came out. Rhythm Heaven is dope, dude. I haven't played one, but they look really fun. And they have the cool music.
I always thought they were like Biting WarioWare.
They're kind of like little rhythm mini games, yeah. But Mega Mix came out today. They actually were teasing it at E3, and they're like, oh yeah, but here's the cool thing. It's just out. And they're like, what? That's kind of cool. I like little surprises like that.
Well, here's me. Here's my best juggling.
It looks dope. I mean, the gameplay is kind of self-explanatory. You just press it. Well, I can't call a game bad, but like I've heard good things about it, and it looks fun to me. I mean, like, it's different, and I've heard a lot of good things from people I trust about it. And it's a rhythm game, it's kind of hard to mess those up.
It makes me wonder if the original game had that problem too, where you had to pause it or else it would just make fucking die. Yeah.
I don't know. That's a good question.
No, it didn't work when I clicked it.
Also, I didn't say it was rad, I said it looks pretty dope. It looks good. Like I said though, it's for 3DS, I think. It's digital only, because, reasons. It's only $30 if you want to go get it. And I guess if you like rhythm games, it's worth a shot.
You gotta believe, clearly.
Also, I don't condone shit-talking games, if you haven't played them. Saying it looks good, though, is fine, because it makes a lot more sense. Unless the game actually looks terrible, in which case, well, not many games actually look that bad nowadays, though. Of course, I say that, and then they're gonna release another Sonic Boom for Wii U thing, and everybody's gonna be like, okay, yeah, you're right. There is that Tetris port. I do remember that. The Tetris game with frame rate issues. Which I didn't even think was possible. I didn't know how you could do that.
Well, you gotta believe.
I mean, Tetris and frame rate issues. Like, that has never been a sentence anybody would utter in any, like, USF4, oh, you're right, PS4 port of that.
Originally, it was like a train wreck.
Well, didn't it get better?
Yeah, it's fine now.
I just remember Guile with the invisible sonic booms. The sonic booms were fantastic in USF4 PS4.
Oh yeah, they were so
weren't
good.
They invisible even,
they
or
were
something?
Literally sonic booms. They had
yeah,
no visible definition.
They were sounds.
That's how it happens when you don't believe. That's
I mean,
what the
like,
song was trying to teach us.
I want Guile to have invisible booms. To make him God's ear.
What do you
the
think?
Fuck?
I always have
the dog, Dudley. I don't remember that
you
at all.
It's your turn. I told you last time. You first.
I need to get Star Fox Zero. I need to try it.
Me too. It was good.
What? They liked it?
The video.
I did
I
good?
Wait, you won?
I actually won? Holy
you
shit!
You won?
I did
you
it!
You fucking won a level!
I did it!
Oh my god!
Alright, I know who I'm
This is momentous, guys.
This is a big fucking deal.
We fucking won! Maybe I'll do a stream of Star Fox Zero. I feel like doing that, maybe. But I need money. Somebody donate $60. No, I'm kidding.
I finally beat one fucking song. I don't even know how I did it.
This is how Make My Video ends.
This
not
is the last,
like,
the Make My Video quadrilogy or whatever.
It's the quad, the four ones?
The quadraxes. Yes.
We need to get him back on the show. He was there once.
I did it the best ever. I beat all of you motherfuckers.
Backyard Betty. I don't know what the, ow. I don't know what that song is.
Holy shit. I beat the game! We actually see the ending.
We won. Holy, you were talking
Seth
about we didn't
Green
beat enough
in this? What?
Did you ever think we'd beat, did you ever think one of the games we beat was a Make My Video game?
No! I don't even, you gotta believe, Homer. That's what this song is saying, you gotta believe.
I
take that
can't
rapper to rapper, Marky Mark on the
see,
fucking
E3 was great this
you
year. Do you wanna know what happened? We fucking beat Make My Video right at the end. E3, best ever, best E3.
Yeah.
Everybody mark that shit down. This is better than the HDFF7 shit. We got this. See this right here. Best E3.
This is what it means to be on top of the world right here.
They should have streamed this on E3. Like, they should have
it's
put
a masterpiece.
The, put this on the main Twitch. We did it.
We did
happy
it.
E3. Are they even still doing E3 streams? It's
think,
over.
Well, yeah, I think they're done now.
But, I mean, hey, no, this is the ending. This is just not streamed on their channel, that's all.
Yeah, this is the this is E3's ending. They paid us to come in and play a game live. So I want to thank our giant audience.
And our sponsors, right?
Yeah, and our sponsors. You can't hear them clapping, but they're clapping very loud. I can barely talk.
See, David Hayes is actually a pseudonym for David Hayter.
Yeah, and, David Hayter was our secret AD.
He was mad at Kojima about Norman Reedus.
So he came to our stream.
He came to our side now.
I don't even know, man. This is like the
They
greatest.
Announced new Make My Video for every console, NX, fucking PS4.5, everything. Everything gets it. Nobody's left behind.
Yeah, this is HD ports of Make My Video.
Nobody is left behind when it comes to a new Make My Video. Nobody deserves to miss this. Nobody. PC, everything. Everything gets it. Mwah.
This is the greatest thing in the world.
Done
this,
it, dude.
This is a moment we've all cherished together. Make the video. Don't tell me what to do, Marky Mark. I beat your game. Fuck off. I won. I did it. You know what? I've never been to Walburgers, but I bet your fries aren't that good. I heard good things about your burgers, but I heard nothing about your fries. So there, I'm saying it.